All right, so first up, I got a couple things, and then you got a couple things, and we have some videos too.
Yes.
So, first top secret is there is the upcoming video that we're going to have. The co-creator of Boglins is going to be at Adafruit.
Turns out Tim doesn't live too far away.
Doesn't live too far away, and we're going to talk about all sorts of things. I only have eye for you. Next up.
There is
the Mini Pi TFT.
Yeah, this little video we showed.
Yeah, we have a little video of the Pi TFT, and we also have a cool little machine learning demo on it. So I thought we would show that, and then also show our Google Assistant video, and then also our little STM32 stuff. So buckle in. We've got a bunch of top secret this week. Here we go.
Okay, I believe this is the smallest, cutest Pi display ever.
Help! I'm trapped in the Pi!
Yeah, and here it is on the other monitor. So yes. What is this?
This is me just trying out this mini Pi TFT. We were showing earlier machine learning demos using our BrainCraft hat, which is a nice large display, but this little display could maybe be useful as well. So this time I'm running the TensorFlow Lite object recognition demo. But it's on the little display instead, and then this camera when I pointed at stuff.
Computer keyboard.
Yeah, and here's what it looks like on the larger screen.
Yeah. I don't like my mouse anymore. Likes the computer keyboard.
Yeah.
Computer keyboard.
All right, cool.
So it can detect stuff as I pointed to it. But what's nice is that this display is really tiny. And if you have a Raspberry Pi Zero with like a hardware accelerator, this could be a little display that would go on top of it.
Hey, Data, what is this?
Well, the BrainCraft hat we've made, we've done a couple of video-based TensorFlow machine learning projects, but now we're going to be doing some audio projects. There's a left and right microphone, headphone out, and two speaker outputs that can connect directly to like a nice big speaker. And I'm actually running Google Assistant. You can see here I got that installed. So let's try it out. Hey Google, what's the weather today?
In New York City today, there'll be showers with a forecasted high of 76 and a low of 59.
Works pretty well.
Currently it's 76 and cloudy.
You done? So for this project, it's not Edge. It's actually connecting to Google servers to do that voice recognition. But this is a great way to get started with voice recognition to test out the microphones and the speaker. And so far, so good.
Is that CircuitPython on an STM32?
It is indeed. This is the STM32F412, which is a nice chip. This one's a particularly big one. And this is the Discovery Board. This is from ST. They make really nice, low-cost dev boards with like all the fix-ins. It even has like these Arduino headers. Pretty cool. They're going to be very handy for soon as we finish porting CircuitPython to the STM32F4. So today I'm testing a pull request on analog input. So here I've got the Moo editor, which is my favorite CircuitPython editor. Real simple, just reading the analog voltage on pin A1 and printing it out. And then Moo has this nice built-in plotter. So yeah. You can see as I twist the knob.
You're twisting here.
I'm twisting here.
And then it's making this.
It's going up and down. So it's the analog plotter. So it's really great for looking. I can quickly tell, like, am I getting smooth inputs.
Twisty twist.
Twisty twist. Am I getting the full range from 0 to 3.3? Yes, I am. So all is good. So this pull request is ready to be merged. So step by step, CircuitPython snakes its way to the STM32.
Cool.
And we've been talking about this for a bit, so here it is.
Yay, I got these. We put them together yesterday, and they work so far. So this is the STM32 F405 Feather with the F405 168 megahertz processor here. 2 megabytes of flash, got that STEMMA QT quick connector, power supply, battery charger, NeoPixel reset, and then on the bottom, I've got SWD and microSD, and I just loaded the Pi board MicroPython build, just like the default one, and it works. Of course, the pins don't match, the names don't match up what it is, but it does enumerate, it came up as a device, and I can bootload to it using the built-in DFU loader, so now I'm just gonna test all the pins, but so far, so good. I mean, yep. It just sort of worked. I don't know. Maybe Maybe I'm a little lucky this time.
More, you know, the harder the work, the harder you work, the luckier you get.
I did spend a lot of time on that data sheet. I was trying to make sure that everything, that's what I got to test next, make sure I2C and SPI works on all the different ports.
And we're working on a case for the Pi badge. We're not going to talk about this because this is a top secret, but this is what it looks like. I'm not going to say anything about it. There's previews. That's cool. And then last up, Lady Ada, I'm going to show the video. What is that Bluetooth thing that we're going to show?
We're going to show a demo of an upcoming addition to the Bluetooth Connect app, which will let you transmit images and maybe even GIFs eventually to Bluetooth boards wirelessly, and it's incredibly fast. So
could even work with like the Gizmo and a Bluetooth
Express. It might be able
to
work with like a Gizmo and a Bluetooth Express. So here's a prototype.
And with that is top secret. Back in the vault, all of you secret things. Okay, if you're in Discord, Adafruit.